bugs on it?
Looks fine.
Okay. Thank you. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jana Balaba Iribaru Dagote Gopi Jana Balaba Iribaru Dagote Nandana Praja Janaranda Huna Suna Nandana Praja Janaranda Huna Jamuna Te Ravana Chagare Yamana te rapanachalde Jai Urad Umadava Kunyabihari Umatuva Kunya Vihari Gopilana Palapa Irivaru Dhabuti Pijana Vadava Idivarudhavuti Gopi Janamalapa Idivarudhavuti Idivarudhavuti Asutanana Raja Januranda Huna Nandana Raja Ranja Yasoda Nandana Raja Jana Ranjana Jabona Tira Panachavati Yamuna Tira Manachari Jai Hurada Madhuva Kunya Bihari Rada Madhuva Kunya Bihari Jai Hurada Madhuva Kunja Bihari Jai Om Vishnupad Paramahansa Paravitakacharya Osutera Sutashi Shimad His Divine Grace Abhaya Charanada Bhaktivananda Goswami Srila Prabhupada Kichai ISKCON Founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Kichai Ananta Koti Vaishnav Vrindi Gajaya Namacharya Siddhahuidas Thakur Gajaya Ren Se Kaho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Paravanichananda Siddhvaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktivinoda Gajaya Sri Sri Radhakrishna Gopikavita Sayam Kunda Radhakunda Giri Govardhan Kijai Vrindavanam Kijai Maturadam Kijai Jagannathasami Kijai Yamunamai Kijai Srimati Lassi Devi Kijai Samaveda Bhakta Vrindi Kijai Gaur Premananda Hari Hari Gaur. All glories the assembled devotees. All glories the assembled devotees. All glories the assembled devotees. All glories to Sri Guru and Gauranga. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Gaur Premananda Hari 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 Gaur. So, Reverend Sundari, you got to put the camera on the verse where we're reciting it. Okay, so reading today from the Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, 17th chapter, text 22. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Whoops. Strong lady. Ta-ta. Uthaya Sampranta Daihamana Rajaukasaha Krishnam Yayuste Shananang Maya Manujam Ishvaram Tathautaya Sambranta Dayamana Vrajaukasaha Krishnam Yayuste Sharanam Maya Manu Jamishvaram Tathautaya Sambranta Ayamana Vrajaka Saha Krishnam Yuste Sharanam Maya Manu Chamishvaram Tathagtaya Samranta Ayamana Vrajaka Saha Krishnam Yuste Sharanam Maya Manujam Ishvaram. Okay. Tataha. Then. Uttaya. Waking up. Sambrantaha. Agitated. Dayamanaha. About to be burned. Vraja Ukkasaha. The people of Vraja. Krishnam to Krishna. Yehu went. Te they. Sharanam for shelter. Maya by his potency. Manujam appearing like a human being. Ishvaram the supreme personality of Godhead. Translation. Then the residents of Vrindavana woke up, extremely disturbed by the great fire, threatening to burn them. Thus they took shelter of Krishna, the Supreme Lord, who by his spiritual potency appeared like an ordinary human being. You can repeat. Then the residents of Vrindavan woke up, extremely disturbed by the great fire, threatening to burn them. Thus they took shelter of Krishna, the Supreme Lord, who by his spiritual potency appeared like an ordinary human being. So purport by the servants of his divine grace, Srila Prabhupada. The Shruti or Vedic mantras state, Sarupa Bhuthaya Nicha Shaktya Maya Kyaya. The Lord's external potency named Maya is innate in his original form. In his original form. Thus, within the eternal spiritual body of the Supreme Lord, there is infinite potency which effortlessly manipulates all existence according to the omniscient desire of the Absolute Truth. The residents of Vrindavan took shelter of Krishna, thinking, this blessed boy will certainly be empowered by God to save us. They remember the words of the sage Gargamuni spoken at the birth ceremony of Lord Krishna. Anena sarva dugani yaya anjas tadishyata. By his power, you will easily be able to cross over all obstacles. That's from the Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, 8th chapter, text 16. Therefore, the residents of Vrindavan, who had full faith in Krishna, took shelter of the Lord in hopes of being saved from the impending disaster threatened by the forest fire. So I'm going to read also Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's commentary here. Rajalkasa refers to those who lived in Braj by doing agricultural work. Krishna is described as Manuja, appearing as a human being in his natural form, Maya. Maya means Surupa. The Shruti says, Surupa Bhutaya Nicha Shakta Mayakyakya. This is the same thing quoted in the other purport. It is called Maya because there's an eternal energy arising from the very Surupa of the Lord. Garga had said that in times of danger, Narayan will enter this boy who has appeared by his mercy and will protect us. This boy will easily be able to deliver you from all types of obstacles. Narayan has now entered into Krishna. So having faith that Krishna now has the strength of Narayan. It's like Krishna's a Shaktivesh avatar or something like that. It's actually quite interesting. This is what they were thinking. We will now take shelter of Krishna to cross over the danger. And I'm just going to read the next verse because my comments are based on both verses together. Krishna Krishna Mahabhaga He Rama Mita Vikrama Esha Gora Tamo Nis Tabakan Grasatehi Naha. And the translation is, Vrindavan's resident said, Krishna, Krishna, O Lord of all opulence, O Rama, possessor of unlimited power, the most terrible fire is about to devour us, your devotees. And Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is a short comment here. The inhabitants called out to Balaram as well because he had also, there's an English mistake in this thing, it says shown, not show. He had also shown that he was omniscient. they infer that he as well was invested with the power of some deva. Actually, I should read Jiva Goswami's commentary. Is interesting. Their method of surrender is described. In excitement or out of natural affection, they call out to Krishna twice. O Krishna, from whom our good fortune arises, Mahabhaga, in your presence we have no fear. O Balaram, with unlimited prowess, by your power, the fire will be extinguished. Recognition of their great powers appeared, but not knowledge of their powers as the Lord. This fire is visible to us and swift and terrifying because it is coming near and we have no escape. It will destroy us completely, grassate. We are yours. They say this to invoke his mercy or to make him understand that they should not be destroyed. By adding the word he, certainly, both boys are indicated since they are both addressed as the beginning of this verse. Because Krishna and Balaram are non-different, the word tavakan indicated yours is the singular, Panini 433 is used to denote both of them. So, Om Gana Timidandasha Gananjana Shilakaya Chakshur Unmiritam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. So, what I'd like to talk about here is the topics of the Srimad Bhagavatam, particularly, of course, what's mentioned here is one of the main topics of Srimad Bhagavatam, which is protection. Or sometimes described as a special favor given to the faithful. And I'd like to read from the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adi Lila, chapter 2, verses 91 to 92, that talk about the 10 subjects of the Srimad Bhagavatam. And then later on, I'd like to drill down into the subject of protection. And one thing I wanted to mention is that generally, devotees think that each one of the 10 cantos deals with a particular one of the 10 subjects of Srimad Bhagavatam. But Srila Jiva Goswami does not actually accept that. That may come as a surprise to all of you. Srila Jiva Goswami says that each of the 10 cantos deals with, and we're not talking about the 11th and 12th, but each of the 12 cantos, let's say, deals with all 10 subject matters. And he said it's a mistake to think that each canto has a particular subject matter, is only that subject matter, or to label a particular canto with that subject matter. This verse is 91 to 92, Adi Lila 2. But Jiva Goswami's commentary is in the, I believe it's in the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Of the 10 factors that we see. Yeah, it's in the second canto, 10th chapter, text 1, where Prabhupada quotes Jiva Goswami. But that's something different. So I just want to make that point because many devotees are taught that each canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam deals mainly with one particular, or can be labeled in terms of one particular topic of the 10 topics of the Srimad Bhagavatam. But Jiva Goswami disagrees with that. So anyway, so apart from that, in order to be considered a Mahapurana, that means a great Purana, you have to have all these 10 topics. The ordinary Puranas, of course, to use the word ordinary, unless they use the word regular, Puranas, they can have 5 of the topics. But the Mahapuranas have 10. So here's the 10. I'm going to mention them very briefly, then I'm going to go to protection. And we can actually analyze in this particular pastime which of the 10 topics of Srimad Bhagavatam are actually being brought out, which is an interesting analysis. One is the creation of the ingredients of the cosmos. That's called Sarga. Sarga, of course, means first creation by Vishnu, and of course that's not being brought out right there. Two, the creations of Lord Brahma, that's called, generally called that Visarga. And then there's the maintenance of the creation. Let me just read it from the purport. That's called Stana. And then Poshana, which is actually the main topic of today, special care and protection for the devotees by the Lord. So I'll read from Srila Prabhupada's comment here, which is actually quite interesting, and then we'll go on to the other topics, and then we'll come back to this. As a king maintains his kingdom and subjects, but nevertheless gives special attention to the members of his family, so the personality of Godhead gives special care to his devotees who are souls completely surrendered to him. And one of the reasons I picked this topic is what we're all going through with Bhakti Chuva Maharaj right now. So that's why I wanted to pick this topic of protection, which is related to the verse and also related to what we're all in anxiety about now. And then the other topics are uti, the urge for creation or initiative power. And then there's the next topic is manvantara, which is the periods controlled by the manus. And it's not only just like the historical record, but it also teaches about the principles for living beings, like the manusamhita and other things that guide us. I was listening to a class that Srila Prabhupada was giving this morning. Prabhupada was quoting from the manusamhita about this specific topic of protection. And of course, it all started out with his discussion about women's position. It was a really controversial discussion with the devotees after Prabhupada had riled everybody up in Chicago. I don't know if you remember that. You know, Prabhupada gave a comment about women's positions and everything like that, and intelligence and everything like that. And then what happened is that the city, one of the city council women refused to see Prabhupada after that. And there was a whole interplay between the devotees and Prabhupada. But anyway, so Prabhupada was talking about protection. And when you talk about protection, in one sense it means someone's weaker. But Prabhupada also said that, let's say, quoting from the Manusamhita, that not only are women supposed to be protected, but Brahmins, old people, cows, and children. So I'm also in that category. So anyways, so that's part of protection. And he says, so this manvantara descriptions actually also deals with protection. And then there's Ishanukata, which is scriptural information regarding Krishna, his incarnations and activities of his devotees, and that's certainly being dealt with in this verse here. Nirodha is not actually being dealt with in this verse because that's the winding up of all energies employed in creation. Mukti, in one sense, is being dealt with in this verse because that's the liberation of the conditioned souls engaged by the gross and subtle coverings, because these residents of Vrindavan are not getting mukti, they're already liberated. They're Krishna conscious, but by reading these pastimes and taking shelter of Krishna, Sharanam is the word used in one of the verses, we can actually get mukti in. And finally, it's Ashraya, the transcendence, which probably sometimes translates as the summum bonum, the complete truth from which everything emanates. And that's also being dealt with here. So, apart from these 10 topics, the primary one that's being dealt with in this particular verse or verses that we read today is the topic of poshanam, the protection of the devotees. And there's quite a bit of information about and stories about how Krishna protects the devotees in the Srimad Bhagavatam. And you have the story of Prahlad Maharaj, right? And Prahlad Maharaj, I mean, when you hear Prahlad Maharaj's story, how his father was attempting to kill him, torture him in so many ways, it's just amazing how the Lord protects him each and every time. Or you have the story even of Ajamil, where Ajamil was confronted with the Yamadutas having committed so many sinful activities throughout his life, and then just by simply chanting the Lord's holy names, he was protected. And of course, there's Ambarish Maharaj, who was basically attacked by a demon created by Durvasa Muni. And he didn't even ask the Lord for protection, right? And what did the Lord do? The Lord sent his Sudarshan Chakra and chased Durvasa Muni all over the creation, everywhere, even to the Lord's lotus feet, and then finally had to take shelter at the feet of the devotee. So, and then we find other instances where it may appear like the Lord is not protecting his devotees. We find other instances, for example, in the Mahabharata, we have the poor Abhimanyu. I know there's a background story to that in the Mahabharata, but there's Abhimanyu, the sons of the Pandavas, and you have all these different personalities, and basically they're getting killed, right? I mean, it's just amazing. And then you just question, or even in the modern day, you know, you have devotees, this is what I wanted to bring out, you have devotees getting sick for one reason or other, devotees having car accidents, and leaving their body in such a way like that, you know, like His Holiness, His Divine Grace, Tamal Krishnamar is leaving his body like that. And you just think, isn't Krishna protecting? You know, sometimes devotees just chanting, Krishna protect me, or we're praying, like people were praying for Prabhupada to remain on the planet, or Prabhupada got gored by a bull, right? Yeah. So what's happening here? Is Krishna actually protecting his devotees? The question I wanted to raise. And I would say yes, because for a variety of reasons. First of all, Prabhupada said, as far as the difficulties the devotees have to endure, and Prabhupada certainly endured many difficulties, it actually glorifies the devotees when they're enduring all these difficulties and continuing to serve in spite. Like when Prabhupada coming over on the boat, having heart attacks, and it's a perfect example of what Tate Nukampam Sushamikshamana Bunjanivatma Kritam Vipakam. Ridvag Bapuravir Vidadam Namaste Jivaita Yo Mukti Pade Sadayabak. We were talking about this last night in class, if you remember. And we said that we made the statement, a devotee, unless it's a pastime like Arjuna, a devotee doesn't have a meltdown in the sense of just like stopping to serve Krishna. Unless it's a pastime. You know, I know Arjuna threw his bow and arrow away. This is a pastime. But a devotee continues serving Krishna. And this is brought out in the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, in spite of whatever is happening to him. And actually, he sees it as a token reaction for his past sinful activities. That's one thing. Of course, other devotees don't take it like that. Like if a devotee is put in difficulty, you don't say, well, he's getting his karma. You know, like for example, the other day I was cooking, like cutting something, like a purvis cutting something, and I cut my finger. So, you know, I can think, devotees should not think, oh, he cut his, no, finger's all right, don't worry, it's still there. So devotees shouldn't think, oh, it's just, he's getting a token reaction for his past sinful activities, but I can take it like that. So anyway, so that's one reason why bad things, apparently bad things happen to devotees, because they're arranged by Krishna to glorify them, to show their great determination. I mean, like you see with, let's say, Jayapataka Maharaj, who had this actually terrible problems, you know, liver and kidneys and everything like that. And that all stemmed, actually, from someone who stabbed him when he was in Spain. They stabbed him in the neck, and then he got hepatitis as a result of that. Anyway, I think you understand what happened. So you may say, wasn't Krishna protecting him? But then you see how glorious he is in spite of all these difficulties. And, you know, someone like me would just say, you know, I'm checking out. Isn't it? Going to Vrindavan, chanting till I die. I mean, you see the people do that even when they're not that sick. But he remains in the battlefield. I mean, this is so glorious, isn't it? It is so glorious. I mean, I can't imagine how his determination, his devotion for Srila Prabhupada, how glorious it is. And so you could say Krishna wasn't protecting him, but Krishna was actually glorifying him, showing his determination, glorifying Prabhupada's determination. So, you know, behind the scenes, you know, you really can't understand. First of all, you're not supposed to understand what's happening with the mind of a pure devotee either. And you really don't know Krishna's plan. You know, sometimes in retrospect, yeah, we can figure out why Krishna did something. But while it's happening, we may not. Like, you know, like Prabhupada had this wife who was, I mean, that appears like a karmic reaction, isn't it? Like, I mean, having a wife who takes your Bhagavatam, steals them, sells them for tea biscuits, and he tells her, I'd rather drink tea than have you around, honey. And, you know, but there's a reason for everything. In other words, when a devotee, like the Pandavas, put into difficulty, I mean, it's amazing how much difficulty they were put in. There was a reason for it. You know, it's a pastime. There's a reason for it. So, for example, let's say if a devotee, I mean, let's take, you know, Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj or Tamal Krishna Maharaj, for example. There's a reason for why that happened. And the reason, you know, I can speculate, you know, my feeling is the reason is that Prabhupada wanted to have them somewhere else to assist him. And actually, Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj, before he left this world, he had a dream. And in that dream, Tamal Krishna Maharaj came to him and said, you know that about this? Well, some of you may know this. Tamal Krishna Maharaj came, you know, Tamal Krishna Maharaj already passed away. So Tamal Krishna Maharaj came in the dream or in the vision, and he said, come, you know, we have to serve Prabhupada. And Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj replied, well, what about all my disciples? How are they going to feel about this? And Tamal Krishna Maharaj said something. This is not the exact quote that Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj told me, but it was pretty much the same thing. But Tamal Krishna Maharaj said, you know, I had to do the same thing with my disciples. You know, they left like that. So there's a plan. And if we look at things from an ordinary perspective, then it appears what happened with Krishna. Did he, you know, is he not present? Did he slip up? I was chanting his names. I was chanting the Lord Nrisingadev. And didn't work. But it did work. Because Krishna's protection, you know, people think Krishna's protection, that your body's going to stay whole for the rest of eternity. You're going to stay young. You're never going to get sick. No. You take precautions. Of course, we've mentioned many times before that Krishna's protection also means to use your God-given intelligence and facility that Krishna has given you like that. Because the residents of Vrindavan, they didn't have any other alternative. It's not that they could call 911 for the fire brigade. You know, just like if there was a fire here, it's not that we just like say, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Can you imagine that? I remember one time there was a fire out there. Well, someone's car caught fire. You remember that? We lost a lot of nice cedar bushes, which are my favorite bushes, in case you don't know. So we lost a lot of cedar bushes because of that. And, you know, we called the fire department. It's not that we went to the deities and said, my dear Radhika Lokananda, the car is on fire. Please put out the fire. But if there was no alternative, yeah, that's the point. And sometimes Krishna puts us in a situation where there's no alternative. You know, you try with the doctors, you try with this. You know, of course, I'm relating this with Bhakti Chumaraj. And then Krishna pushes us in a situation where we just like have to chant intensely, please, isn't it? Like with Prabhupada, it was like that when Prabhupada was leaving the planet. I mean, people were chanting intensely, just remembering Prabhupada, praying for Prabhupada. So that, you know, there's another reason why Krishna puts his devotees in difficulty to connect other devotees, I mean, his followers or his well-wishers with that particular personality, and to realize the nature of this world, to realize that there is no material solution to anything in this world. To realize that, and another point is, to realize how short this life is and how much we have to do for Krishna before, in our own personal Krishna consciousness, and how much we have to do for Krishna for the movement, and how important it is, I mean, in these particular cases, to keep the older devotees. I mean, actually, there was a person outside. He said, he was a doctor. He said, you have to make sure the leaders of your movement stay around as long as possible to set the standards. I mean, I was thinking about this in regard to the GBC service that we have, is that so many times we're passing these resolutions that really could be done by other people instead of dealing with, you know, Siddhanta and Tattva. You know, we're dealing with, you know, everybody should eat pakoras every day. You know, I'm not saying there's a resolution like nobody should use plastic bags. There's another resolution. But this is not, I mean, obviously it's important, but it's not primary importance. So it also, these circumstances teach us that while those devotees who are with Prabhupada, you know, Prabhupada disciples or those who are with Prabhupada are around, we should take advantage of their association. I mean, just like, for example, I've been corresponding with Tejas. I don't know if you know Tejas. And he's extremely sick right now. And every time I tell him, I say, you got to finish your book. You know, he's writing a book of this amazing book, which I have in an unedited fortune, an unedited version, which I can't share with anyone else. But it's an amazing book of, like, intimate things about Prabhupada you've never heard before. So I'm telling him that, yes, you got to finish it. I mean, this is a wake-up call, what's happening with Bhakti Chumaraj. It's a wake-up call. Because this now it's important to establish the very foundation of our society. Other things can wait. Even constructing temples can wait. You know, the temple of Mayapur, you know, which everybody considers so important. I mean, it is important. But it can wait. That's not really the foundation. The foundation is like Prabhupada, teachings, hermeneutics, how to understand Prabhupada. Like that, how to structure the society. I mean, these things are very important. So anyway, so what I'm saying is that when a devotee has to go through these things, it's not a lack of Krishna's protection. It's Krishna's plan. It's Krishna's plan for the person's service. It brings a person closer to Krishna. I know when something, of course, something not so disastrous has happened, but, you know, when things happen to me that are just really painful, you take it as Krishna's plan. It's not that Krishna's neglected me. You know, you don't say, you know, my father, why hast thou forsaken me? But, you know, we may think like that for a second, but he hasn't. Krishna hasn't. And we don't understand all the aspects of Krishna's plan, but that is actually his protection. That is actually protection. And we can't always expect, like, Krishna, if we fall off a cliff, to Krishna come and catch us like that. Isn't it? I mean, that's, you know, you have these stories in the Bhagavatam, you take them out of context in application. So we are responsible. We have to learn. And Krishna is always protecting his devotees, although Krishna doesn't do his protection in the way that we would like him to do. But it's for the best for everyone all around. And it's painful to hear that, but it's just, we have to have that faith in Krishna, that Krishna is in charge. Not a blade of grass moves without the will of the Lord. And as Krishna says in the sixth chapter of the Gita, that one who sees me everywhere and sees everything in me is never lost to me, nor am I ever lost to him. So I think this is important. So this here, the residents of Vrindavan, obviously it's a different situation. Their only resort is Krishna. Krishna is protecting them. But Krishna also puts them into difficulty too, for various reasons. I mean, Krishna leaves Vrindavan, and that is the greatest pain, more painful for them than leaving their bodies, is Krishna leaving Vrindavan. So, on that happy note, not happy, it's not happy. We'll see if anyone has any questions. Yes. Yeah.
Forgetting Krishna or not getting a human body or losing our connection with the karma or guru. That's the greatest fear. So Krishna's going to protect us from that.
Yeah. Yeah, there's no guarantee Krishna's going to protect us from death. Well, Krishna will protect us from death in the way that our Krishna consciousness continues. Swapamapyasya dharmasya trayate mahatobayat. But not that this body, I mean, if Krishna wants, yes, we won't get sick. And if Krishna doesn't, and if Krishna wants, we will get sick. But we have to take precautions at the same time. And then we pray for the devotees and try to understand Krishna's plan and all this. Okay. On that happy note, anyway, we have to greet the deities. Sorry about that. On that note, did this thing go out? I hope not. Ooh. Okay. It got most of the class. Okay. Yeah, I think so. I wonder what happened here. Jai Shri Shri Radhagalukananda, Radhagalukananda ki jai.
Govinda, Hari Purusha.
Shesha.
La Seigneur.
Shivad, His Divine Grace Abhaya Chalanar Bhaktivananda Goswami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai ISKCON Founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Anandakoti Vaishnava Vrindigajai Namacharya Shidahuirastakur Gijai. Ram Sekaho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shidwaita Gadadha Shivasati Gaur Bhakta Vrindigajai Sri Sri Radhakrishna Gopakavata Sayam Kunda Radhakunda Giri Govardhan Kijai Vrindavanam Kijai Maturam Kijai Jagadatasami Kijai Yamunamai Kijai Shimati Lasi Devi Kijai Samaveda Bhakta Vrindigajai Gaur Premanam